Hello and a very warm welcome to Rajya Sabha TV. I'm Ashwarya Kapoor with Verdict 2014, featuring all the news and updates on the assembly elections in Maharashtra and Haryana. Let us begin by taking a look at the headlines. Chief Election Commissioner's suggestion that paid news should be made a poll offence finds widespread support. Majority of respondents back suggestions in reply to Law Commission's query. BJP stalwarts hit a campaign trail in Maharashtra and Haryana on Sunday. Modi, Rajnath vow not to campaign against Shiv Sena to mark respect to Bal Thackeray. Congress raises price rise issue and Modi government's failures in poll rallies in Haryana. Father-son duo of Hooda highlight achievements of Congress government in the last 10 years. And Congress leader Prithviraj Chavan denies NCP's allegations of being responsible for split in alliance, says his style of functioning irked the NCP. Chief Election Commissioner's V.S. Sampath's suggestion that paid news should be made a poll offence has found widespread support. Now, a majority of respondents to a Law Commission consultation paper have backed the suggestion that paid news should be made an offence under the Representation of the People's Act. Now, there were a range of recommendations regarding the enforcement mechanisms that should be put in place to monitor and restrict the proliferation of paid news. One of the suggestions was to make political advertising free and be made available to candidates on a transparent and equal footing. On Sunday, Sampath had said that paid news should be made an electoral offence that attracts disqualification so that it acts as a deterrent.
The district level committees are very active about detection of paid news, and this drive will be continued. Whatever cases are detected, prompt action will be taken to book it to the expenditure of the candidate.
Meanwhile, BJP stalwarts hit the campaign trail on Sunday in both Maharashtra and Haryana. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed rallies in Sangli and Kolhapur in Maharashtra. He said that his party will not come campaign against its former ally Shiv Sena as a mark of respect to Bal Thackeray. Home Minister Rajnath Singh was also on the campaign trail in Maharashtra, while BJP President Amit Shah addressed rallies in Haryana's Ganor.
On the second day of his poll campaign in Maharashtra, Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed two rallies in Sangli and Kolhapur. Addressing a huge gathering in both rallies, Modi said that he will not target his campaign speeches against BJP's estranged political ally Shiv Sena. He said the decision has been taken in a mark of respect to Sena's former patriarch Bal Thackeray.
Aaj kuch akhbar ke panditon ne likha hai ki Modi ne apne bhashan mein शिव सेना की आलोचना नहीं करते हैं भाइयों बहनों बाला साहब ठाकरे की गैर हाजिरी में महाराष्ट्र प्रदेश का यह पहला चुनाव है और इसलिए मैं बाला साहब के प्रति अपनी श्रद्धा और आदर को व्यक्त करने के लिए शिव सेना के खिलाफ एक शब्द भी नहीं बोलूंगा
Modi also criticized NCP and Congress in his speech at the campaign rallies.
Congress party mujhe pooch rahi hai 60 saal hue jo desh ki gadi par baithe the rajyon ki gadi par baithe the panchayat se parliament tak sab jagah pe unhi ka jhanda phairta tha 60 saal tak ek chakri raj kiya tha wo 60 saal ka to hisab nahi de rahe hain मोदी से 60 दिन का हिसाब मांग रहे हैं
Home Minister Rajnath Singh also addressed a rally in Yavatmal. He claimed that BJP will work for development of the state to help those who are economically weak.
जिस भारत में 65% आबादी नौजवानों की हो जिनकी उम्र 35 वर्ष से कम हो और जिस भारत में प्राकृतिक संसाधनों की कोई कमी न हो फिर भी भारत आज हमारा दुनिया का सबसे गरीब देश माना जाता है क्यों ऐसे हालात हैं
BJP President Amit Shah was in Haryana on Sunday to address a rally in Gannaur. Among other BJP leaders, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj and Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan are also scheduled to hit campaign trails soon. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
All right, my colleague Rajkamal Rao is now joining us for more on that story. Rajkamal, now it is very interesting how the political pundits are really looking at those election rallies by Narendra Modi. But those words that he spoke, that the very fact that BJP and he himself would not say a single word against Shiv Sena, and also a blistering attack on NCP leader Sharad Pawar there, how are political pundits looking at this?
See, it's a very good political strategy for both BJP and Shiv Sena, because BJP's state leadership has problems with Shiv Sena, but at the national level, BJP's leadership like Amit Shah and Narendra Modi, they never had any issues with the Thakres, in fact. So Uddhav Thackeray never said anything against Narendra Modi, so Narendra Modi reciprocated the same thing in his rally address today. So Uddhav Thackeray and Narendra Modi, they will not criticize each other so that their post-poll alliance can stay intact. In case if BJP fails to get the minimum number, which is 145, or Shiv Sena fails to get the minimum number, they will have a partner once the post-poll scenario emerges. NCP is under attack by every political party, including Congress, because many political parties believe that the cadre of NCP is still intact in Marathwada region, other region. So NCP can become a competitor for these political parties. So they want to counter NCP first, then think about other political parties. So This kind of situation will remain intact and will continue in further rallies also.
Also, Rajkamal... This is a very interesting point that you made, but also very interesting is the fact that this rally is taking place in the Sangli district. Now, it has some political significance because the last elections, assembly elections I'm talking about, there were some polarization of votes after obviously what the violence had happened. But things have drastically changed for all the parties now. How's the equation for all the parties as far as these assembly elections are concerned?
BJP's target is very simple, Ashwarya. They want to have Modi's rallies in almost every district. There are 35 districts in Maharashtra where BJP can gain a momentum in 25 plus districts. So. In urban areas like Pune, Mumbai and Nagpur, BJP is a bit strong, but rural districts like Sangli, Kolhapur, Sholapur, where Modi addressed rallies today, their BJP party cadres are weak because they were depending on Shiv Sena in the last 15 years. So once Shiv Sena cadres are moved out of the alliance, which is Maha-yuti, BJP has no other option because they lack state leadership. Gopinath Munde is not there. So Modi is the only choice left for BJP for all campaigning things. So even the state leadership like Devendra Fadnavis or Vinod Tavade cannot go and campaign in these districts because they are also contesting assembly elections for the first time. BJP MLCs are contesting elections for the first time, so they have to focus on their constituencies. Sangli happens to be the constituency and the home district of present Chief Minister Prithviraj Chauhan, so it has also a significance for Modi to attack Congress and NCP alliance so that he can attack those opposition party and garner support in that district that has witnessed some kind of communal violence in the past. So obviously the parties will try to garner that.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Rajkamal, for joining us and sharing your perspective on that matter. We'll keep coming back to you. Meanwhile, seeking a third straight term for Congress in Haryana, the father-son duo of Bhupinder Singh and Dipinder Singh Hooda addressed two rallies in the state on Sunday. Well, BJP was the primary focus of both the leaders in their campaign speeches in Ambala, Cantonment and Bhiwani. Here is a look.
On Saturday, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched his poll campaign in Haryana by targeting the Hooda government for allegedly being anti-farmer. On Sunday, Congress hit back at the Prime Minister in two rallies. First, incumbent Chief Minister Bhupinder Singh Hooda addressed a rally in Ambala Cantonment, accusing the Modi government of failure in its first few months in power. Hooda raised the issue of price rise and highlighted Congress's contribution to assure rights for everyone. He also dismissed any chance of a Modi wave in Haryana.
हरियाणा सरकार अपनी तरफ से 2.5 किलो दाल हर महीने 20 रुपए के हिसाब से देती है ताकि गरीब आदमी का गुजारा हो और सारे मनरेगा में कितने काम हुए सारे अधिकार दिए फिर भी भारतीय जनता पार्टी का बहुमत कैसे आया लोगों ने भारतीय जनता पार्टी की नीतियों और कार्यक्रम पे वोट नहीं दिए पॉलिसीज और प्रोग्राम पे वोट नहीं दिए लेकिन फिर भी बहुमत आया इसलिए कि पूरे देश में खासतौर पे उत्तर भारत में एक माहौल बनाया गया। किन किन ताकतों ने साथ दिया उनकी चर्चा नहीं करता, लेकिन कुछ देश की ताकतें इकट्ठी हो गई।
His son, Dipinder Singh Hooda, also addressed a rally in Bhiwani on Sunday. With its key opposition INLD considerably weakened by the imprisonment of its top leader, Dipinder Hooda also chose to target BJP in his campaign speech. He accused Modi of misleading people by ignoring Haryana's achievements under Congress rule.
ये सरलता से लोगों को गुमराह करने वाली बात जिस प्रकार से भारतीय जनता पार्टी कर रही है, इस केवल कह के हरियाणा की उपलब्धियों को नकार के काम नहीं चलेगा। उनको ये बताना होगा कि भाई ये क्यों कर रहे हैं, भारतीय जनता पार्टी हरियाणा के अंदर क्या करना चाहती है, ये बात अपना एजेंडा लोगों के सामने खोल के रखें और लोग गुमराह ना करें, मेरा उनसे यही कहना।
Chief Minister Hooda maintains that during the Congress rule in Haryana, the state has become number one in the country in terms of per capita income, per capita investment and resource mobilization. He remains confident that Congress's poor showing in the Lok Sabha polls will have no effect in the assembly elections. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Right, my colleague Ravindra Shuran is now joining us on the phone line for more on that story. Ravindra, it was really a super Sunday as far as the election rallies are concerned in the state of Haryana. How are you looking and how the political pundits also looking at the two rallies that we saw by the father-son duo of Hooda family?
Yes, yesterday also we have seen it. This was a very tremendous amount of energy has been injected by the two leaders. Also, yesterday we have seen that the Prime Minister of India addressed one rally in Karnal and the Congress President also addressed one rally in Haryana. In Haryana now, the campaigning is in full swing. Tomorrow also the PM is going to address a rally, election rally in Hisar. The importance of Hisar, I must tell you, is that this was the constituency which the BJP and the alliance partner FJC could not win and the seat went to the INLD. Hisar along with the Sirsa were the only two seats in which the principal opposition party of the state, INLD, could win. The important point in this election is that the INLD, the principal opposition party in the state, is contesting this election, as you said, as their top leadership in the jail. Only two days back, the former Chief Minister Om Prakash Chautala has started his campaigning, but his campaign is now under the legal consideration, means there is chances of interim bail can be revoked as the CBI has already approached the High Court asking that this is only interim bail on the medical grounds has been granted to the former Chief Minister of Haryana. So he should not be allowed to campaign. Also, the President of Congress, Sonia Gandhi, visited state yesterday. She, along with the Vice President, Rahul Gandhi, will address many more rallies in Haryana in the days to come. So the election is in full swing in Haryana. This time the election is tough for all the political parties, though it is tough to forecast the election results. But it seems that the next assembly, the next assembly could be a hung one. Yeah.
Right. Thank you so much, Ravindra, for those details. Election campaigning in Haryana and Maharashtra raising a feverish pitch there. Meanwhile, the war of words between the Congress and the NCP continue in Maharashtra. Former Chief Minister Prithviraj Chauhan once again blamed Sharad Pawar's party for breaking the alliance with the Congress. Now, addressing a rally in Nagpur on a Saturday night, Chauhan claimed that NCP had put an impossible demand of sharing the Chief Minister's chair. He also said that he was not popular because of his style of functioning. Now, taking a dig at the NCP chief, he claimed to have cleared over 40,000 files during his tenure without a controversy. Earlier, NCP chief Sharad Pawar and former Deputy Chief Minister Ajit Pawar accused him of being instrumental in splitting the alliance and also threatened legal action, in fact, alleging controversial clearance of files.
करण्याकरता आम्ही बसलो. पूर्व अटी घातल्या 30,000 पाहिजेत. पुरानंतर अट घातली की मुख्यमंत्री पदाची 5 वर्षाची मुदत आहे आणि 3.5 वर्ष दोघांनी वाटून घेतली पाहिजे. अचानक नवीन अट, अचानक 30,000 मागणी.
And NCP Chief Sharad Pawar's daughter, Supriya Sule, has also hit the campaign trail in Maharashtra. Addressing a rally in Chandrapur on a Saturday night, Sule raised the issue of corruption in her speech. She accused BJP of having double standards while dealing with allegedly corrupt leaders within the party. She asked why dissident NCP leaders who switched to BJP were given clean chits despite having corruption charges against them.
जी से एक ही सवाल पूछना है कि हमारे जो दो लोग भाजपा में गए हैं दोनों पे भ्रष्टाचार के आरोप है और वो साबित नहीं हुए तो वो मोदी जी को और भाजपा को कैसे चलते हैं.
And the Election Commission will send a senior official to Jammu and Kashmir next week before taking a call on holding the assembly elections in the flood-ravaged state. Deputy Election Commissioner Vinod Zutshi will visit Jammu on 8th of October and Srinagar the next day to review the situation with officials of the State Election Commission and the state government. He will also be meeting the representatives of major political parties to seek their input. Now, one of the main concerns of the Election Commission is the condition of the polling stations and also the road connectivity. And another area of concern is the revision of electoral rolls, which had been underway before the floods hit the state. The revision was expected to be over by the first week of October, but it has now been delayed. The term of the 87-member state assembly ends on 19th of January next year. Well, time to take a very short break here. More election news coming up after a short break. Stay with us. Welcome back after the break. Now, people in Maharashtra's Vidarbha region have been demanding for a separate state for a long, long time now. But there has been no headway in the last 20 years. The issue returns to focus every time the state goes to polls. Here is a special report.
Ever since Telangana became a state, the demand for statehood of Vidarbha has gained momentum. Unlike public rallies or agitations in Telangana, Vidarbha movement is largely on paper. People in Vidarbha are advocating for a peaceful solution to their demands.
We are feeling that we are getting stepmotherly treatment, and please see to it that if this doesn't, this continues this way, there is most likely that separate Vidarbha will get moment very fast. And maybe a day will come that though it is on paper, it will come on street, then it may take a violent turn, which is not good. In Telangana, so many people left, you know, they gave up their life. So after, say around, say maybe 100 people have died in that Telangana, now they have come up with a state, fine. So what did they did wrong? That 100 people, who's accountable for their life? That when you had to give it, do you want bloodshed on, you want people to die, you want properties to be destroyed, then only you will understand that the demand is there.
Vidarbha region in Maharashtra has 11 districts. Nagpur is the main divisional headquarter that served as the capital of old CP Berar state. It had the entire infrastructure in place in its capital city, Nagpur.
Maharashtra ka budget 1,25,000 crore se lekar 1,40,000 crore tak ka salana budget banta hai. Us salana budget mein se 10,000 करोड़ रुपया भी विदर्भ के लिए महाराष्ट्र सरकार विकास के लिए नहीं निकालती है.
विदर्भ स्टेटहुड डिमांड गोज बैक टू 1950s. दिस केदार कमीशन अपॉइंटेड बाय यूनियन गवर्नमेंट एंड फर्स्ट स्टेट्स रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन कमीशन हेडेड बाय जस्टिस फजल अली रिकमेंडेड विदर्भ एज अ सेपरेट स्टेट कंसिडरिंग द अनटैप्ड वेल्थ पॉपुलेशन एरिया एंड डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम कैपिटल. एज पर द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ऑफ महाराष्ट्र 2012 विदर्भ रीजन जनरेट्स 10,000 मेगावाट पावर विच इज अबाउट 60% ऑफ महाराष्ट्र टोटल पावर कंजम्पशन. The region also accounts for over 5,000 million tons of coal production. According to Vidarbha Economic Development Forum, the region's population figures are similar to that of Punjab and Chhattisgarh. The GDP of the region is more than that of Chhattisgarh. But presently, it is the second most underdeveloped region in India. Situated about 10,000 kilometers from Mumbai, the region is a less preferable destination for industries.
I mean, the reasons are sheer political in nature. Nobody wants to leave Bombay. Nobody wants to, break up. All political parties, when they are not in power, they are the first ones to promise us to fight for the cause of Vidarbha statehood. But the moment they get into power, the scene is entirely different.
Only 6% employment is there, if you see. Yeah. Per capita income is lowest. the region which was a developed region has now gone to a stage which is now underdeveloped. It's not even semi-developed.
Political parties like BJP, Shiv Sena and Congress had promised that they will support the creation of a separate state. Nitin Gadkari and Babu Rao Motemwar went on to give it in writing during Lok Sabha polls. But no one came forward after polls. Experts say that the political intensity shown by TRS or GMM is missing here.
Government of India have not done anything for it. The Bharatiya Janata Party, who are running this government and leading the country, have assured to the Vidarbhites that if their government will come in the majority, they will definitely do the separate state of Vidarbha.
Negligence has led to unemployment in the region. It is one of the reasons why Gadchiroli district became a safe house for left-wing extremists. People says statehood can be the only solution to the end of the crisis.
People in Vidarbha region have been demanding a separate state for Vidarbha. But lack of political will and lack of public movement has made it only limited to paper. With camera person Shivakumar, Rajkamal Rao, Rajya Sabha TV.
And farmers in the Vidarbha region face a deep financial crisis. The ever-increasing debt burden has forced several in the last 2 years to end their lives as well. Here is a special report on the farmers' financial crisis in Vidarbha region.
Cotton grower Shyam Rao has borrowed this piece of land he's sowing on. Rao hopes that this next crop will give him yield to pay back the debt he has amassed over the past 4 years. Rao had taken a debt of 2 lakh rupees from a moneylender in 2010, which he could not repay. Unable to pay, Rao's cousin committed suicide in 2010. To add to the debt, the rate for borrowing land is not cheap. He has had to pay a guarantee of 50,000 rupees to a fellow farmer for this land.
ऐसे क्या वो काश्तकारी लगाते हैं?
जी.
पानी से बोए जाते
हैं?
हाँ. इसलिए आत्महत्या कर जाते हैं कोई कोई.
अच्छा मतलब पैसे नहीं मिलता?
हाँ पैसे नहीं मिलता भाई देख देमा हमारा वो खेत देखो.
हाँ.
पूरा आधा आधा खेत पानी से गया.
हाँ.
ठेका से वो ठेके वाले से ठेका देना पड़ता हमको.
There are thousands like Shyam Rao. Maharashtra's Vidarbha region has lost at least 3,000 farmers in the last 6-7 years to unpaid debts. Farmers borrow from moneylenders at high interest rates, making themselves vulnerable. Mahesh Sangram, an agriculture awareness volunteer, gives us the reasons behind growing numbers of suicides.
कम से कम 800 से ज़्यादा रुपए लगते हैं. और एक एकड़ को खर्चा कम से कम तो आता है वो 40 के आसपास आता है.
40,000
के आसपास आता है. इससे वजह से कपास इतना पैसे जो मिलता है होता ही नहीं. इसकी वजह से आत्महत्या करते हो.
द महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट हैज पास द मनी लैंडिंग एक्ट टू कीप अ चेक ऑन इंडिविजुअल मनी लैंडर्स. Under the act, moneylenders will be imprisoned for 5 years for imposing elevated interest rates on farmers. The act has a retrospective effect going back to 1999. This election season, farmers are demanding a compensation package for delayed monsoon and they want the government to effectively control moneylenders.
Farmer suicides have been a sad reality of Vidarbha region in Maharashtra. Previous governments have implemented schemes to reduce the number of suicides, but they have not been succeeded. In this time, in the upcoming assembly polls, farmers have high expectations from the next government. With camera person Shivakumar, Rajkamal Rao, Rajya Sabha TV.
And known as the Orange City, Nagpur's farmers want the government to establish industries to make products like juices and medicines. As of now, Nagpur does not have a big industry. All the oranges produced here are exported at cheaper prices. Our correspondent Rajkamal Rao has this report.
It is the beginning of orange season in Nagpur. The wholesale market is receiving tons of oranges for trade. Farmers from nearly 200 villages bring in their truckloads of oranges to the market. Orange farmer Jagdish brought 200 kilos from Haridaspur and is waiting for a trader. He says the best quality oranges are exported to Delhi, Mumbai and Hyderabad in large quantity at cheaper prices.
यहाँ की मंडी ज़्यादा चलने के बाद फिर आजू-बाजू की मंडी चालू हो जाती। तो संतरे कहाँ लाने का? वहाँ संतरे अपन ने डाले, तो वहाँ अच्छा रेट मिलता नहीं। एक दो दलाल रहते वहाँ पे, यहाँ पे हजारों ने दलाल है, इसलिए यहाँ माल लाते।
Nagpur earned its fame as Orange City because of the quality of the fruit produced. They have the maximum pulp in comparison with oranges produced in other areas. The best quality oranges called Ambia Bahar are exported to the US and Brazil. But small farmers are forced to sell other varieties of oranges at cheaper rates to preserve them in cold storages.
तीन चार टन माल लेना पड़ता है सत्य एक साथ कहीं अपना बियापुर जाता है माल कहीं नागपुर जूस कंपनी वहाँ जाता है तो उनको रेट में नहीं पड़ता।
As per the report submitted by National Research Center for Citrus to the Maharashtra government, oranges produced in Nagpur can be exported if adequate storage facilities are provided. The report says that more than 25% of the oranges produced in farm get damaged before reaching the market. This is Rajkamal's Rao report from Nagpur, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, that's all in this edition of Verdict 2014. But keep watching Rajya Sabha TV for more news and updates. Goodbye.